I don't think I go back full 10 years, but it must be 8 or 9. And I was trying to recall the first moment I heard you guys play. It took me a little bit of time to learn how to spell Spuyten Duyvil. Didn't take me very long to love what they do. I mean, how can you not, right? You have Beth's just totally enchanting vocals. Mark's artistic vision, you've got the talents of these amazing musicians, and they take this music, which sort of feels like it has a little, you know, foot in the tradition, and they make it so contemporary with such energy and such chops. And let's face it, the career has just gone up and up, you know. They went from Westchester to the West Coast, conquered most of New England, and, you know, festivals and awards and all that stuff, but you can find out on the website. You don't need me to prattle on about it. There are reasons that they're taking a bit of a hiatus. I don't know whether Mark will go into it, but, you know, he's opening a board game cafe uptown, and I understand that Beth is getting into ESL. ESL teachers are saints, Beth, and somebody's moving to somewhere. Is that you? Yeah. And Jeremy's getting into this whole career as a guitarist and fiddler and singer-songwriter. So, you know, I don't think we have to worry about these people, you know, continuing to make a career. It just won't be this particular configuration for a while. The one hidden talent you may not know about, you know, about Mark's talent as a smoker. No, I'm not talking about inhaling.
One time during college. Yeah.
And he never exhaled, right?
That's right. I had the
privilege of having dinner at their wonderful house up in Yonkers a couple of times, and he had in the backyard, the smoker, and you'd have brats or brisket or whatever, and great cook, great food. I have a feeling this band will be smoking tonight, though. Yeah. It's going to be Old Home Week and a very special occasion. Spuyten Duyvil.
Our dear friend, dear friend.
Thank you all so much for coming out. We are so glad to be here in our very favorite place to play on the island of Manhattan. Here's a song Mississippi John Hurt made famous. It's called Hot Time in the Old Town Tonight. 1, 2, 3, it's gonna be hot time in the old town. I want you to come and go with me starting. Thank you all so much, boy. This is a great place to play, and it's so nice to see it so full of so many friends of ours. So, I don't know, I'm a little verklempt. All right, so we're going to do a mix of old songs and new songs. We're going to bring up some guests to play with us tonight who have played with us over the years. And this is a new song not recorded. This is one of Beth's. Am I right? Am I doing it right?
Yes,
I even got it right. I even introduced the right song.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
For every one of these guys that were up there with me. It was the most beautiful thing. We had such a nice morning. And we've done that a lot over the years, you know, and that's the thing. It was just like after 10 years, you know, it's...
You still better do it.
Oh, yeah. So come for brunch.
Just because we're not playing right now doesn't mean you're not going to be beating us.
Here's a mashup of a couple of old-timey tunes. It's called Come On In. One.
Thank you.
with my lips out now. Oh, now she's sitting in another man's lap. Come on in, ain't nobody here but me.
Sometimes you gotta work forever on songs, and sometimes you just wake up one morning and they're all there together. So this is one of those, and it just woke up one morning singing it, trying to figure out for months where it was from and who wrote it. And I couldn't find hide nor hair of it. And I said, okay, it's mine. This is the process, right? Some people work at things. I just get this little gift from wherever. And then one day I was listening to this other song and I was like, oh, that's where it came from. So we're going to do them both together. It's still mine, still mine, still mine. But we're going to do them both together and you will get it when we get there.
You guys know this tune. In fact, you probably know both tunes. Actually.
I'll bet there's some of you who know this tune and you can help us out. You just have to shout. It's a non-patronizing audience participation. I'm not going to explain it.
Thank you.
the OG Spuyten Duyvil, the original band members, Sarah, Tom.
Sarah, come on up. Tom Socol. These guys started it all with us, and we kind of started out on our porch. Dear friends and neighbors, we're so psyched they could come tonight and join us. So we're going to do a tune right now. This is probably one of the oldest Spuyten Duyvil tunes, for me at least, because this is actually a song that I was thinking about before there was a band. It was one of those songs that I had in my head and I knew it, and it was a song that I imagined, wouldn't this song be so cool if we could do this with a band? And Mark and I started noodling around with it, and one thing led to another, and our neighbors came and joined in, and yeah, one thing really did lead to another, didn't it? It's kind of amazing. So this song is called Rain and Snow. It's a beautiful old traditional. I'm sure some of you guys know it. Again, I'd welcome you to all join in if you know
happier and prouder, makes us happier and prouder than being able to bring our daughter Dena Miller onto the stage. She is making quite the name for herself under the moniker Deer
Scout. She's hard to get on stage these days. She's in demand.
Yeah, we had to fly her in and stuff. Alright. Hey Joe.
Yeah,
load on
in.
Load on in. Alright, so everybody give a warm welcome to Dena Miller, huh? This next tune we're going to play is on the Social Music Hour Volume 1. We were all done tracking the record. We weren't going to do this tune. We were going to do it, but I couldn't. I often sing this. I couldn't sing it because I was in the room with the drums and stuff. Dena was walking home in from school, and I was like, hey, kid, you remember this tune? She's like, yeah, I think so. I handed her the lyrics. One take. Yep. One take all the way through. That is what's on the record. There we go. One, two. One, two, three, four.
If I could have
another good friend of ours, Mark Newman. Mark Newman, where are you, man? Where is Mark Newman, man? Okay, so this is a song. So first of all, I just want to say thank you to everybody. I want to say thank you to Rockwood Music Hall. Rockwood has been a great friend to this band. We were on this stage when we hardly really kind of only sort of deserved to be here. So,
We want to say thank you to Adam and Will on the sound.
All right, so I asked Jim to do that because I always like forget and I can't remember anybody's names. So he hands me a piece of paper in the middle of the show. That's not what I wanted you to do. Thank you guys. You guys are the best. This is always the best place to play. We just walk on stage and we play. Let's have a big round of applause. This is a tune called Peace with the Damage. This is one of the tunes that I wrote that I don't exactly know what it means, and everybody seems to imprint their own troubles and trials and tribulations on. So
that's
if you're feeling shitty,
song.
If you're feeling shitty, this one's for you. Here we go. One, two, one, two.
Tell your lies. I feel
Geser on the drums. And now I'd like to bring back to the stage, on the drums, our greatest liability, Jagoda. Hey, and Cousin Steven. Where's Cousin Steven? Get something to bang on. Come
so
on
these
up.
Guys are coming up on stage, and this is it's a special night for us, as you can see. So as part of this special night, we'd like to invite you after the set to join us in the back bar. Got some goodies from Katz's. And it's we're going to discount some of our CDs, all of our CDs, actually, and
we're t-shirt giving them away.
Giveaways. Well, we're not giving away the CDs,
the
but the t-shirts we are giving away, so you all can walk out of here with a t-shirt tonight. Feel free, go to the back, rummage through the box, find your size, good to go. And that way we will keep...
Clear that with the business manager.
And this way, we get to keep Spuyten Duyvil on your chest and alive.
All right, here's a little Tommy rock and roll for you. Oh, we're doing Yusuf Bob. This is not anything like what I just introduced. I knew I was going to do it once.
Used to be wild, let the day turn into night, into morning. Sun coming up with no warning. But like a wave that washed your shoes into the sea, and your heart like a ramshackle house, shackled to your hometown history. California. Yeah.
started as a little barbecue and jam on our porch about 10 years ago, and I just got to say, we with this band and these great people, we just got so much farther than anything that we ever possibly dreamed of, especially starting to play music, which is a young person's game at 45. So I just want to say thank you to everybody in the band, everybody who's played with us, everybody who's booked us, and I really want to say thanks to John Platt, because John Platt introduced us. If there's anybody out there in the band that's getting started, if you get John Platt behind you, you've got the killer advantage, man. He gets behind you, he supports you, and he doesn't let you go, and thank you very much, John. This is a little old-timey rock and roll.
Watching you smile,
walk that straight and narrow line between the moral and the immemorial urge to do the wrong thing every time. Me wrong.
No,
when I'm done, take me all the way home.
From Bobtown, you guys know this lovely lady, good friend, and an amazing musician.
Kat helped us with all the background vocals on our records.
You were there. I bet my last 100
songs. Well, that bar was
again, but thank you so much for all the times you came to see us. It's a real dream come true for me to be in this band and be able to play this music with all these beautiful people. So.
Come on back.
So this is a song that we played pretty much every gig we ever played. So that means we probably played it like 400 times and it just never ever gets old.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Thank you. when this is all done, we're going to fly away.
Yeah, that's fair. All right, Jeremy, it's all you.
No way.